Hey everyone, and welcome back to Doki Doki Night Nurse, where we have this scary-ass music playing that's really creeping me out. So previously, I locked myself into one of the endings, where we have fully submitted ourselves to Sayori. Meanwhile, Kotonoha and Mio are exploring around Sayori's house looking for answers. So here we go. Upon finishing our search through the first floor, there wasn't anything else of note to help us figure out what Sayori was up to. We opted to begin searching the second floor, where we might hopefully find something helpful.
I'm going to assume Sayori's bedroom is on this floor. Most likely. In that case, we might find something in there that might tip us off. In most cases, a psychopath would have some sort of private chambers for themselves. Well, assuming Sayori is a psychopath...
I'm a psycho.
Are you sure you haven't been watching too many movies, Kodo?
As I'm about to speak out, we hear what sounds like muffled screaming from one of the rooms. We both exchange nervous looks as we proceed with caution. Mio gets right behind me as we approach the door, where the muffled screaming is the loudest. I nervously reach out and grab the Nord. I flub up my words, and then I nervously reach out and grab the doorknob. I open the door gently. I peek my head from around the door to find myself looking at what I'm assuming is Sayori's bedroom. I open the door a little more and tread carefully inside, Mio following close behind me. There's no one in here. So what could that sound of...
That sounded like it came from the closet!
I look over in the direction of the closet. I hold my hand out to signal Mio to stand back. She gives a nervous nod as I slowly walk up to the closet door. Which, well, we kind of assumed that this would be the closest thing to the closet that's in this room, so... Anyway. I shakily place my hand on the knob. I once again gently open the door.
Wait, Sayori? She's tied to a chair with her mouth taped shut. How in the name of...
I rip the tape from her mouth.
Ow! That hurt, you know! Sayori? Yes? What are you doing here? How did you get back into the house without us noticing? What are you talking about? I've been tied up and trapped in this closet for the longest time!
Mio slowly approaches me, only to stop upon stepping on something. She moves her foot away to find a pocket knife.
What's this doing here? That's a knife the other me stole from Yuri.
Oops, nah, Sayori, Yuri, that happens sometimes, so sorry.
Other you? Yeah. What, do you think I tied myself up to this chair and locked myself in the closet just for fun? Well, from the stories Daniel was told, well, I didn't do this! It was the other me walking around with the blue bow! The blue ribbon? We saw you going over to see Daniel a while ago. You were wearing a blue bow. So, what you're trying to say is... She's an imposter!
Gosh, Sayori, you're looking awfully sus lately. Okay, no.
At least, she looks like me, but she isn't me! I'm not sure what's going on, but I can explain it to you later. Just untie me!
Mio takes the pocket knife and makes her way into the closet. She begins cutting the ropes, restraining Sayori. Upon being freed, she attempts to stand up, only to stumble. I'm able to catch her before she falls to the floor. I walk her over to the bed.
It's been 2 days since you... went missing. Have you had any food? The other me only fed me a little bit, just before you all got here. I am kind of thirsty, though. Mio, see if you can get her a glass of water. I'm going to stay here to try and figure out what's going on. You've got it!
As Mio scurries out of the room, I set my sights on who I presume is the real Sayori.
You said that other Sayori was an imposter. I don't know how to explain it, but she looks, sounds, and acts like me, but she's not me at all. She was just in my room all of a sudden one day when I was getting out of bed. I just took a few steps, and then I felt like lightning hit me. The next thing I knew, I was seeing that other me wearing the same pajamas as me. Same pajamas, but with a different bow. Yeah, that's it exactly! When I asked her who she was, she said she was Sayori. When I told her that I was Sayori, and that couldn't be possible, she freaked out and called me an imposter. I tried to go for Mr. Bat to try and defend myself, but she got to him first and knocked me out. Mr. Bat?
Sayori points to the bat lying in the corner next to the closet.
The next thing I knew, I was tied to this chair and in the closet. The other me got dressed in my uniform and said something about making Daniel realize her true feelings for him and not letting anyone get in her way. Here's your water, Sayori. Thanks, Mio.
Sayori takes the glass, nearly gulping it all down.
Hey, don't drink it all so fast, Sayori. So then the Sayori that's been taking care of Daniel has to be her. Wait, what?
I briefly summarize the events up until now as best as I can, starting with the phone call from Daniel about how he was sick. When I started talking about the other Sayori, or how this other Sayori was taking care of him, Sayori's face was stricken with fear.
We can't leave him alone with that skunk bag!
Sayori immediately stands up and walks in front of her closet.
I don't know what she's planning on doing with him, but we can't let her get away with this. She's kidnapped the other girls and taken Daniel hostage. I'm not going to take this lying down.
I'm a bit flustered when Sayori starts to pull up on her pajama shirt.
Sayori! Oh my!
Mio covers her eyes and turns away, her cheeks turning crimson.
What? Oh! Sorry about that. You can change your clothes when we're out of the room. You said the other Sayori kidnapped the other girls just now. Do you mean the literature club? Yeah, but I'm not sure where exactly. I just know she mumbled something about keeping them in the house to make sure they're not in the way. I hope they're okay. Okay, well, change out of those clothes. Mio, see if you can find the literature club girls. I'll go with Sayori to confront the imposter. No, it's okay. This is something I have to do on my own. Sayori, are you sure about that? Do you think you can handle her? She caught me by surprise before. Now I've got the element of surprise on my side. She won't know what hit her.
Sayori looks over at Mr. Bat as she says this.
Very well, then. We'll look for the others. You take care of yourself, Sayori. Do you hear me? Got it!
I close the door as Mio and I step out of the room.
Are you sure about letting her take on that imposter Sayori on her own? No. When we find the other girls, I'm going to dash the house. I can't follow her right now, otherwise she'll suspect something. Alright. Gosh, I hope we can do this. For all our sake, I hope so too. Are you sure there isn't anything else you can do? Well, there is one thing I could do.
Okay, and I'm gonna make a save like a smart person should have. It's not a big deal, but still, I should have. because I know what's coming up here. So get my notebook ready here.
Something you could argue I should have done in the first place.
Okay. So, in this case, we are going to... We are going to make the call. What call exactly?
You'll see!
Hesitantly, I pull out my phone and begin to dial.
Who are you going to call?
Ghostbusters! No.
Send backup.
Meanwhile, we're having fun, happy times back at the house. I know Sayori told me to stay in bed, but I can't help myself as I try to sneak up on her.
Are you sneaking up on me?
I slowly approach her. She hasn't noticed me yet. Well, I won't question it. I put both my hands on her shoulders. She's like, what's going on?
Hey! Ah! Give me everything tonight! Get away from me, neighborhood prowler!
Sayori then starts slapping with a spatula.
Wait, what the? Sayori, stop it! Sayori, stop! Daniel? What did you do that for?
Todd in the shadows told me to do it. Okay, no. I just felt kind of bored without you, so I decided to try out something I heard in a song once.
A song told you that?
Yeah. It's just to grab someone sexy and tell them, hey, give me everything tonight, or something like that.
Oh yeah, I think I remember that song. Anyway, you're supposed to be in bed.
Aw, but it's so boring without you.
Sayori, this is boring! I hate this bed rest thing! Aw, I know, but I still have things to take care of down here. I'll be right with you soon, Daniel. You need to get plenty of rest, you know. You're not going to get better if you keep putting stress on yourself.
It's a small price to pay for spending time with you.
Now, Daniel, I know what you're trying to do. You're not going to get the best of me here.
Well, darn.
You're so ridiculous sometimes, you know.
I know you are, but what am I?
Okay, you win. Just promise me you'll get back to bed soon, please.
Alright, you have a deal.
Good. Anyway, I was trying to see if I could bake some brownies. I know how much you love them, so I figured I'd try to get some ready for you.
Nice.
I can't wait to see how they come out. I was going to surprise you with them, but I guess the secret's out now.
I'm sorry, but you know how I get when I'm away from you for too long? In the last few hours, I found myself wanting, no, craving, to be with Sayori as always. I don't think I was always like this. No, you were not. I don't know what's come over me all of a sudden. I know! I don't know if the readers slash players and viewers have caught on, but I'll clue them in afterwards, somehow. It's as though someone flipped a switch in my head. And I know who did it! I can hardly remember anything about my past that didn't have anything to do with her. Literature club? What is that? I don't even remember what I did this morning that I was so worried about.
Well, at least it's more fun to bake with a partner, right?
I'm still sick, though.
You won't handle any of the kitchen stuff, but I would love the company.
Then allow me to honor your wishes, m'lady.
My, always the gentleman, aren't you?
Oh shit, that actually scared me. As I follow her into the kitchen, we're both caught off guard by the sound of a bat, by the sound of the door swinging open, and someone yelling while flailing a bat.
Who the hell is this person? Get away from me, get away from me! I'm armed, I'm crazy, and I'll hurt you! You again? What the?
Who are you? I'm Spider-Man.
Get away from her, Daniel! She kidnapped me and the other girl so she could have you all to herself! Imposter! I should have known better than to show you mercy! You can't have him! Daniel is my life! My world! My galaxy! You're not taking him away from me!
What? What the hell is going on right now?
No time to explain right now. Just know that this skunk bag showed up in my room 2 days ago and locked me in my closet. Your room? You mean my room? You're the one who just happened to show up out of nowhere. Don't listen to her, Daniel. She's just trying to confuse you. I know that you know which of us is the real Sayori.
Oh, hello. Knife versus bat, who wins? I stand beside my one and only girlfriend, taking her hand in mine as she takes up a knife. You're right. And I accuse you of being the imposter!
Daniel? What? What are you saying? It's me!
You're nothing but a fake. I don't know who the hell you are, but I want you out of my sight.
No. No! No, 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 no! No! Cry all you want, you good-for-nothing faker. He's my boyfriend, and you're not taking him from me. Boyfriend? Daniel? What is she talking about? What did you do to him? What do you mean? We just confessed our everlasting love to each other, that's all. There's nothing wrong with that, is there? But I love Daniel! Ever since I was little, I've always loved Daniel. Don't you remember? How we first met that day and you saved me?
I don't care who you are, but you're not going to fuck with my head anymore. I've never even met you, yet you're saying you've known me since you were little? I don't buy that.
No. No! You heard him. Now get out. Leave. Right now.
It's the heat! We're caught off guard once more by the sound of sirens blaring outside and footsteps approaching the house.
This is the police! Drop your weapons and put your hands in the air!
Both Sayori and whoever the hell this is drop their weapons and comply. I love how she's like,
oh, you're gonna get it now.
I do the same, not wanting to land myself in hot water.
Oh my god.
Yeah, so. We didn't. I mean, there's no police for Doki Doki Literature Club out there. But these are some sprites left over from the planned Detective Natsuki mod that we had in mind. So you might say they got to see some second life here. You know. And if you have a problem with it, well, like I said, just use your imagination. We tried, okay? A few police officers approach us with handcuffs. Maybe someone called the police because of all the shouting going on. In that case, they're here to take this raving lunatic calling herself Sayori out of here. I'm shocked when they said put handcuffs on Sayori. My girlfriend. What? What's going on?
We're taking this criminal away! We received orders from the chief to take her into custody for several counts of kidnapping and taking hostages. Apparently, whoever made the stress call... whoever made that call stressed that the girl in the blue bow was the culprit. I didn't know what they meant until I saw it with my own eyes. It's like someone out of them Spanish soap operas.
You mean the evil twin thing?
Eh, something like that.
Wait.
No, you can't take her away. She's my girlfriend.
Oh wait, there's four of them!
Daniel! Where are they taking me? Stop! Let me go! I can't leave my boyfriend behind! He needs me! go already! Sayori! Come back!
You can blame it all on me!
Okay, no.
Sayori! Poor kid.
Seems like he's already been brainwashed.
Brainwashed? Is that why he's acting so funny? A lot of kidnappers tend to do that sometimes. It's like what they call Stockholm Syndrome, you know? Thank you so much, officers.
No problem, little lady.
We're always glad to help the chief's daughter.
Well, I can only look on in horror as Sayori is dragged away by the police, kicking and screaming in a vain attempt to get away. I try to go after her, but these two girls restrain me.
Let me go! I have to get to Sayori! Daniel, that's not the real Sayori! What has gotten into you? What are you talking about? They're taking Sayori away! I can't live without her! But Daniel, I'm Sayori! She's nothing but an evil lookalike trying to seduce you! She's not evil, she's my girlfriend!
Buddy, I hate to break it to you, but your girlfriend is evil. Just because she's your girlfriend doesn't mean that she also can't be evil. Just look at Destro and the Baroness. They're both evil, and they're both dating.
Listen to yourself. I'm your friend. We were all worried about you. The only friend I need is my girlfriend.
I take advantage of their confusion to break free from the grass, but sadly it was too late. I watch in horror as the car with Sayori speeds away, Sayori looking back at me with tears in her eyes. She's screaming something, but I can't hear a word.
Sayori! Sayori!
Desperate, I break out into a sprint, using all my strength to go after her. No.
No!
I said I wasn't going to lose her again.
Damn it, I'm not letting this happen.
I refuse!
Daniel! Stop!
I hold a hand up to Sayori. Tearfully, I shake my head. Sayori, tears in her eyes as well, looks on as Daniel runs after the police car like a mad dog.
I don't know what's happened to him, but it seems like he's gone now.
His mind is gone. Nothing but a waste of what it once was.
Gone? He made it sound as though your evil twin was trying to seduce him. As much as I hate to say it, your childhood friend is gone now.
Twisted by the dark side, young Skywalker has become. The boy you trained, gone he is. Consumed by Darth Vader. Or in this case, lust.
He's been consumed by lust.
So yeah, that's the idea here. Evil Sayori kind of had him under a spell of sorts. Starting with the soup, and then kind of going into how she was, like, really seducing him. To the point that, well, you might say that she was kind of acting like a succubus, in a way. Although she didn't look like a succubus, obviously. Because, oh no, we weren't gonna go there with that. At least, I wasn't sure if that would have worked in the end, so... Yep, so basically... Yeah, MC was basically caught in this spell of lust by the false Sayori.
Whatever she was trying to do with him, it seems she was successful. What do you mean? How do you know that? You probably wouldn't believe me if I told you, but let's just say my mother has shared some stories with me. Some of them kind of similar to this, from back when she was a little girl. Is that why you believe this whole crazy story? Perhaps. To be honest, I think the stories my mother and I could tell you are far more bizarre.
I wrap my arms around Sayori as Mio and the rest of the Literature Club girls pour into the living room. Confused, I did my best to try and explain what transpired, as well as relay Sayori's story as best as I could. They were taken aback, as to be expected, but I told them Sayori's story with conviction. The same conviction Daniel had when he turned to me for help. Several weeks had gone by ever since the strange encounter with Sayori's evil twin in her abduction of the literature club. I would like to say things slowly returned to normal, but I cannot. Heaven knows those are the words I would like to say to describe things, but that would be a lie. Daniel never returned home, nor was he ever seen again. Every so often, I would drop in on the literature club just to check on things. Sayori was never quite the same. I later learned that she suffered from depression from her and Monica, which only worsened my fears. It was a very dark and depressing day when Sayori did not come back to school for a few days, just after the last time I visited the other girls. I later learned from Cousin Yuri that it was because Sayori had sadly taken her own life. I was devastated upon hearing this news. According to Yuri, the only clue as to why she did that came in the form of a note she left behind detailing her spiraling emotional state and her broken heart and mind. It wasn't enough that she lost her best friend. No, if anything, she lost someone who meant the world to her. Someone she dreamed of confessing her love to in the purest, innocent fashion, like something out of fairy tale romance, gone forever. In her heart, there was no one else. Now he was gone forever. To add insult to injury, he had fallen for the other Sayori and not to her, denying her and saying this carbon copy was his true love. It seemed to be too much for her. This entire experience was very scarring and traumatic for her. Those self-deprecating thoughts consumed her until she couldn't handle it anymore. I wish there was something I could have done, but Monica and Yuri tearfully told me that she was too far gone, and there wasn't anything else we could have done. Natsuki was the most frustrated about everything, cursing Daniel for breaking Sayori so badly. I wish I could tell her about my suspicions as to why he did that, but it would be unwise to do so. I would only endanger myself and Yuri in doing so. I am reluctantly forced to keep this information to myself. I have never met him face to face, but my mother and I have known him all our lives. I feel deep down this is his doing. As if I needed another reason to resent him, now he has chosen to stir chaos in our otherwise peaceful lives. He has no sense of guilt or shame. All he desires is entertainment, as he manipulates the unsuspecting victims he claims as his puppets. You've ruined the lives of two innocent people who were secretly in love with one another. You've affected the lives of those around them as well in the process. I curse your name. I curse everything you stand for. A name that my mother warned me to never speak aloud. Tarankos. Dance of the Puppets. The very questionable ending. I originally wasn't going to include that ending, but then I got this idea after remembering some of the negative comments made about Captive Hearts. About how, you know, if we go back to the whole thing with Monica being a murderer in that game, the MC should have just called the police and been like, nah, I ain't going with that. So I decided, you know what? I'm gonna make the quote-unquote logical ending here. Where someone calls the police, they arrest the evil Sayori, and then everything is... Well, you would think it would be all fine and dandy, but then I decided... Well, how would I even do that? So I figured that this route would have been really one of the only more suitable places to have that. Alright. So, instead, now, we are going to proceed with the plan. Yeah, I think we have time for... Yeah, if I make these videos like an hour each or so, we have plenty of time.
No. I shouldn't. We've already gotten this far on our own. Doing that would only complicate things further. Gosh, I hope this is the right decision.
Well, I could tell you, but that would ruin the surprise at the end. Okay. So, yeah, basically now we're gonna have this whole thing repeating itself. We're gonna get slapped in the face with the spatula. Allow me to honor your wishes, m'lady.
My, always the gentleman, aren't you?
As I follow her into the kitchen, we're both caught off guard by the sound of the door swinging open and someone yelling while flailing a bat.
Who the hell is this person? Get away from me! Get away from me! I'm armed, I'm crazy, and I'll hurt you! You again! What the... Who are you? Get away from her, Daniel! She kidnapped me and the other girl so she could have you all to herself!
Okay, well... Let me see here... Okay. So, we had her going, get out, leave, right now. It's the end of you and me. It's too late. I can't wait for you to be gone. And all that, so... In this route, however, she ain't backing down.
No, I'm not leaving! Not until you let Daniel go free! He doesn't want to go with you! Don't you see? We're in love now, and there's nothing that'll change that. You... I hate you! I love Daniel! Why are you stealing him from me? Stealing? It's not my fault you didn't ever act when you could. My life, my friends, my best friend, and the only guy who ever mattered to me. You've taken everything away from me! I don't even know who you are.
Sayori brandishes the knife and aims it at the intruder, who seems to get the idea and starts to back away. As Sayori attempts to rush at her, the intruder seemingly gives up and runs out of the door. Our forbidden loves seems to have been revealed. What do we do now?
I think we've overstayed our welcome here, my love. I think it's time we leave and find a place where we will be accepted and free to express our love as we please.
I love the way you think. So now they're gonna run off together and maybe... I don't know. Well, we'll see. I run over to the house, hoping I'm not too late. I kick myself for not going with her from the beginning. I should have, but sadly I didn't. As I approach the doorway, Sayori comes running at me, full speed.
Sayori? What's going on? Kono! Daniel! He... and her...
Sayori drops the bat as she begins to sob uncontrollably. I pull her into my arms and hold on to her tightly.
Sayori, get behind me! I don't know if she's still in there, but we ought to try and confront her before it's too late. Oh, okay.
Sayori and I break apart from each other and she gets behind me. I pick up the bat and we slowly walk inside together. I'm surprised to find the ground floor is empty. I can't see or hear anyone else besides the two of us in the house.
What? Where did they go? Sayori, I hate to put you under pressure, but can you tell me what happened?
Sayori quickly recounts what happened after she barged into the house to confront the other Sayori. Apparently, Daniel seemed to be so incredibly smitten by this doppelganger that he refused to recognize Sayori as the real her.
He kept saying he loved her. She said they were in love and nothing was going to get between them. Oh, Lord, no. I have a feeling I know why Daniel was acting this way. I wish I was wrong, but all the signs point to one thing. Or rather, to someone whose names I dare not speak aloud. What? What is it, Kodo?
Wasting no time, I begin scurrying through the house, trying to look for any sign of them or a hint to where they could be. I rush into the bathroom, and to my dismay, I spot an open window.
Use your imagination!
That's what PBS Kids taught us! Below it, there's a bathtub. I climb up to the window and look outside. This leads to the backyard.
Did you find something, Kodo? I hate to say this, Sayori, but I think Daniel ran off with the other you.
They're gonna go to Vegas and elope.
No! No!
As I step down from the window, Sayori pushes me out of the way and tries to look out the window in vain for Daniel.
Daniel! Where are you? Come back! Please come back!
To say this experience has broken Sayori would be an understatement. I manage to pull Sayori away from the window and into my arms as she cries her heart out. I cannot. I will not forgive him for taking Daniel away from us in this sickeningly cruel twist of fate. Never. 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 When I met up with Mio and the rest of the literature club, Sayori and I tried to explain everything as best as we could. As bizarre as it all sounded, there was no other way we could explain everything. We spoke with conviction and emotion. Cousin Yuri managed to help back me up. I gave her a knowing look, and she simply nodded solemnly. Okay, well, let me see here. So Daniel never returned home, nor was he ever seen again. I told my father about what happened, and we kept it in mind to keep track of anything that could have led to him. There were rumors about someone matching his description. Okay, it looks like I was kind of joking about the whole going to Vegas to elope or whatever, but I guess I actually did put that there. Well, yep, I guess the only one who really understands my mind is me. There were rumors that someone matching his description was seen at a rather shady chapel eloping with a girl that looked like Sayori, but then the trail went cold afterward. Mio and I did our best to comfort and be there for Sayori, but at the end of the day, there was only so much we could do for her. In the end, there wasn't anything else we could do. Okay, now... I've never met him face to face, but my mother and I have known him all our lives. I feel deep down this is his doing. As if I needed another reason to resent him, now he has chosen to stir chaos in our otherwise peaceful lives. He has no sense of guilt or shame. All he desires is entertainment as he manipulates the unsuspecting victims he claims as his puppets. You've ruined the lives of two innocent people who were secretly in love with one another. You've affected the lives of those around them as well in the process. I curse your name. I curse everything you stand for. A name that my mother warned me to never speak aloud. Tarankos. someone dares to speak my name. The descendant of a traitor, nonetheless. How interesting. I did not expect to see her get involved. I must keep this in mind for the future. I would say this dark copy of that other young woman proved to be quite useful, and my experiment was a success. Perhaps she did not turn out to be as much of a worthless creation as I hypothesized. Excellent. Most excellent indeed. Bad ending. My favorite game. So, I guess for those who are a little bit confused in this, for this ending, well, for the most part, if it isn't quite as obvious, well, so Kotonoha and Yuri are related. They are cousins. Both of their mothers are sisters. And this kind of ties into Wicked Witchcraft, actually, another mod that we made, where Sayori is a witch. Or, no, I keep doing that. Where Yuri is a witch. And she even name drops Kotonoha as being her cousin as well. And essentially what it boils down to is they are descendants of a clan that worshipped Taronkos. But their ancestors defected. So that's how they know about him, and basically, you know, they've kind of kept this secret for as long as they've all been alive. Okay, now then. Well, actually, as much as I hate to say it, I think this video is probably gonna be a bit shorter, just because this next path is actually gonna take a little bit longer to get through. So there would be no way for me to squeeze it all into this one video, unless you want this video to be like almost like what, 2 hours long maybe. And I don't know, some people probably don't like that, but you know, I feel like this is probably the best option here. So that does it for this route, which I would basically say that in this route, the evil Sayori is successful in seducing MC. So now, we're gonna go down the other route and see what happens when MC resists her and she isn't successful. Alright, well then, thank you all for watching, and I will see you guys next time with whatever else I do. Stay golden, and later, folks.